I'm Dr. Kylie Dodsworth, and I'd like to talk to you about irritable bowel syndrome because it's such a common issue. So many people come in saying that their digestion's not right, or they've been told they've got irritable bowel syndrome. But what's really interesting is that we've given it a name, but we don't often do anything much about it. So in normal medicine, you might have a colonoscopy to have a look inside and make sure you haven't got any polyps or a tumor or something else going on. But that's looking at the structure of the bowel. It's not describing or doing anything about the function of the bowel. And that's what's gone awry when you've got irritable bowel syndrome. And the very name tells us something about it. It says it's irritated. So what we need to be doing is saying, well, why? What's causing the irritation and why isn't it working properly? So when the bowel is irritated, the symptoms that go along with irritable bowel are things like feeling bloated, or we might feel that we're getting a bit of cramping pain, or people often will describe going from loose bowels or diarrhea to actually being really sluggish and having constipation. And it's that switch from constipation back to diarrhea and bloating and pain that causes people to seek out some help. So those symptoms are telling us that there's something that's not right. So we need to ask the question, what's gone wrong? And there are quite a few common things that can be a problem for the digestion. So one thing to consider would be something like food intolerances, really quite common. So a lot of people will be a bit intolerant to dairy and maybe to wheat or gluten. Sometimes it's eggs, sometimes it's yeast. There can be a range of different things. And food intolerances are different to actual allergies or serious anaphylaxis or problems where we need to have the adrenaline injections. Intolerances are more of a subtle thing. But if we have got food intolerances, we need to sort them out. Otherwise, our gut will not function properly. So that's a bit of a journey to go on to understand for yourself what are your intolerances. Beyond food intolerances, we might actually be lacking in our digestive enzymes. We might not be making enough stomach acid or a good pancreatic enzymes or bile for our fat digestion. So if we don't have the right enzymes there, we can't break down our food properly, and that causes irritation in the bowel. Beyond that, it might be about having an overgrowth of things like candida or yeast in the bowel. So that can cause lots of problems for people as well. And then finally, the complications of what we call the microbiome or the bacteria that live in the bowel is a really complex area that we're finding now that we can understand it a bit better. And an imbalance in those bacteria actually causes lots of problems. So we need that bacteria in the gut because it actually does a lot of our digesting for us. And there's huge amounts. It's like 3 kilograms worth of bacteria sitting in our bowel. But it's needing to be in the right balance. If it's not in the right balance, it won't do the digesting in the right way, or it'll make waste products or byproducts that can be irritating for the bowel. So getting those bacteria correct is really important. So we can actually do testing of the microbiome or the bacteria so we can understand for you individually what's going on with your bacterial population. And then correcting that makes all the difference. It's important to know that taking things like probiotics and prebiotics that feed those bacteria, that can be helpful, but it's a tiny fraction of the actual population that lives in your bowel. So we can begin with things like some probiotics and prebiotics. We can take some digestive enzymes. You might want to look at food intolerances, but if it's still not settling, you need to go on that journey of actually being tested around the microbiome or the bacteria and then rebalancing the whole family so we've got better health in the bowel. So at the end of the day, you know you're there because you'll be having no bloating, no pain, and you'll be using your bowels once a day or twice a day with well-formed and easy to pass stools. So that's what's normal, and we need to go on the journey until we get there because digestion is so important. It's where we get all our nutrients from for running the whole body, and our immune system lines our gut. So if our digestion's not working right, we often get problems with immune function and autoimmune conditions as well. So this journey to health in your gut is absolutely vital. So let's keep working with that so we can get you back and have, you know, really start to create better health. So I'm Dr. Kylie Dodsworth, and if you have any questions, you can find me at the website. You'll see the details below. Bye for now.